नमस्कार, मेरा नाम आशुतोष भोगना है और मैं इंडियन कंप्यूटर इमरजेंसी रिस्पॉन्स टीम में एज ए साइंटिस्ट डी कार्यरत हूँ। इस सेशन में वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सोशल इंजीनियरिंग, व्हाट इट इज़। सो सोशल इंजीनियरिंग इज़ द मैनिपुलेटिंग द ह्यूमन बीइंग, ट्रिकिंग देम, ल्योरिंग देम। सो दैट्स द सोशल इंजीनियरिंग। सो द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस सेशन इज़ टू अंडरस्टैंड द सोशल इंजीनियरिंग and define the goals of social engineering, the impact, what the impact of the social engineering can be, the types of social engineering, and the sign, how you can recognize the sign of social engineering, and the defending against the social engineering attacks. So social engineering techniques. So what is the social engineering basically? Social engineering is the manipulating the human being, manipulating your tendency to trust. So suppose I will call you, hello, I'm your friend, friend of your friends, and then can you give me and help me in this way? Can you provide me your password? Or maybe the other example is that, hey, I am calling from this bank and your password is logged and you have to provide these details and OTP numbers. And then, so those techniques of manipulating the human being is the social engineering techniques, and those techniques are used by the attackers, hackers, to compromise the systems or to attack the network of your organization. So what types of social engineering techniques are there is the there in this slide. So social engineering techniques like can be a shoulder surfing. Shoulder surfing means someone is standing behind me and looking what I am typing or what I am pressing. So that's the shoulder surfing. And there may be the phishing attack, and you receive a email stating that please fill your username password in this bank website since it need to be reset, some contextual email, and then you click and provide it. So those are the phishing attempts. There is a dumpster diving. So like we are throwing out a papers from our office or maybe, and then someone may look at those papers and those documents and can gather the information and the crucial information about the organization. So then there is a Trojan horses, the malware. Trojan horse means which listen installed into your computer and listen and monitor your activities and transfer the details to the attackers. So there are those techniques. Then there are pop-ups. Sometimes on your screen the pop-ups comes up saying that you need to clean your system, antivirus pop-up or some advertisement pop-ups. Those pop-ups or forms are a social engineering techniques that may steal your data. So these are the techniques generally employed for tricking the people. Then there is a phishing also. Phishing is over the phone. Over the phone, someone is calling and tricking the users to provide the sensitive information like a card details, password of a server, bank details, things like that. So if we look at the formal definition of a social engineering, so it's the manipulating a person into knowingly or unknowingly giving up information. So the objective is to manipulate the person so that it reveals the information to the attacker. So that's the basically the psychological manipulation or tricking or luring the individual for the information gathering. And understanding social engineering. So social engineering is the art that refer to the psychological manipulation of the people. It is said that the human are the weakest link in the cyber security, and it's very easy to trick the human being. So what is the need to run a sophisticated tool to compromise a firewall or server when by a simple call, giving a call to a help desk or an engineer and manipulating them, I can get a password, the attacker can get a sensitive information. So what is the need to run a sophisticated tool to compromise a server? So that's the social engineering. It's a low hanging fruit. Anyone can do it to trick the users. So like we see in many spam mail you may be receiving in your inbox. So saying a lottery email or some gift is coming to you or some bank related. What are these? These are the phishing attempts. These are the attempts to lure you. These are the attempts to trick you. So either you will provide the information or click on the link or download something into your system that is the malware that will further snoop into your computer and provide your information to the attackers. And then what the attackers will do with your information is to misuse it or the launch attack against your organization or to do the financial fraud if the is attack is on the individual. So one of the ways to looking that you may have visited the websites and they have a secret question type of a thing. So if you forget your password, use a secret question. So secret question is the what is your first school, what is your maiden name, what is your birth city. So those are the simple questions, they are just secret questions. And these are the information easily provided. So these are the information can be easily collected from your social media accounts, or you can provide to your friends, or you can provide over the phone also, or to different platforms. So suppose I know the question, so I know the answer, I know your pet name, I know your favorite color is blue. And then what I can do, I can visit that website and ask for I forget my password on your behalf, and then I provide secret answer, the favorite color is blue. So I can get access to your account. So those are the misusing the information, revealing the information, misusing. So why the social engineering is effective? So it's our tendency to trust, it's our tendency to believe. So it's the interaction and with the attackers, and they are tricking the people. There is no such policy or a progress to ensure the complete security from a cyber social engineering attacks, because there are various ways. So there is we cannot place a firewall there, we cannot create such a policy there. Only the answer to the problem of a social engineering is the awareness of human, so that you will be careful, cautious against the attempt of a social engineering. Employee of an organization be cautious about this tricking from the getting tricked from the malicious attackers. So the attack cycle, if we will see the attack cycle of social engineering, this is the research, first finding out and gathering the information about the target, and then developing a rapport and trust with that fellow, maybe over the call or maybe over the email or the other ways, and then exploiting that trust factor, getting the information, and then after getting that information, utilize that information, execute on the target, and then recruit and cloak, means the hiding the details and path of attack, and then evolve that attack into the further damage to the organization or individual. Fetch information, so these are the methods in social engineering used to fetch information. So you know the we already discussed these phishing fake pop-ups. So malwares are also there, so to snoop and to steal the information, or to first the thing is that using the social engineering to trick the user to installing the Trojan horse or a backdoor into their system. So these are the methods. So then in details you can see various type of a social engineering, physical attempts, physical penetration attempt, physical attempts, or the over the email, over the phone, like a phishing, wishing, and whaling is also there. Whaling is the targeting the high profile people. It's similar to phishing, but it's the targeting the high profile the executives of an organization. Then there is a physical attempt, like interacting with different peoples and different employee by visiting your facilities. So those are the different type of a social engineering. So other common type techniques are the impersonations. So hey, I'm calling from this bank, hey, I'm calling from health tech, hey, I'm calling from your bank, I'm calling from your boss office. So trusted authority, so as a trusted authority attacker believe and ask for information. So you please provide this information, bank information, otherwise your card will be blocked. So those type of threats and tricks are made by attackers, and then they push the victim to reveal the information. Computer based is the pop-up which generates websites. So some websites are there, emails are there, chain letters are there, hoaxes are instant. You are getting those things in your box and inbox and this pop-up in a Windows always is, it is there, which is asking for some information from the victim. So those tricks are there. Tools, if you want to learn about the social engineering, how it is easy it is to do, different ways to do it. So I suggest you to explore the social engineering toolkit. Social engineering toolkit is the platform, is a tool that help you to create a social engineering attacks. So social engineering attacks means malicious website you can create, malicious pen drive, malicious emails and the spam emails you can create. So you can see, you can use this tool for a good of your organization by educating them that how the attackers can trick the human being. So how can they trick the victims? So that you can use this tool for the purpose of education or conducting some short exercise within an organization for the awareness purpose by sending a email or launching a attacks in a control environment using the social engineering toolkit. So this toolkit is available in a Kali Linux Backtrack that you can download. It's an open source operating system, customized operating system for vulnerability assessment and penetration testing and security, other security tasks. So you can use that for that and explore the social engineering toolkit. One interesting thing, the category is there, quick response code is there. So generating a malicious quick response code. So what is the quick response code? If you are aware that instead of typing a complete URL into your browser, mobile browser, what you can do? You can point to the quick response code and your browser will take you to the automatically to the encoded URL. So in the case, what will happen if that is a malicious quick response code? It will take your browser to the malicious domain. So you can generate, basically you can see how the malicious quick response code can be generated from the social engineering toolkit. To understand social engineering, I must say that you must explore this tool. So what are the benefits defending against the social engineering? So you know that, what is the first thing you know, that it's the awareness. Employee awareness is the security awareness. So awareness is the key to defend against the social engineering. Then there are a policies like a password policies, then there are exercises, then there are authentication and multiple authentication based mechanism, layered security, things like that, though that can be taken for the defending against the social engineering. So we have listed a few best practices also. So to you, so never disclose. So the rule, the basic rule is that need to know basis. You should not disclose the information if it is not required by a person. So don't get tricked. Be aware about the threats and type of techniques used by the attacker. So limited information should be provided and should be disclosed about as an individual or about an organization. So be restricted on your social media profiles. Limited information should be uploaded there. What you are uploading as a picture, what you are uploading as a details, you have to see what information I am revealing and I am uploading on the internet that may be used against me. And if you are getting some suspicious email, so you have to investigate, you have to see that in details. Should I click on it? Should I open it? Be aware of those threats. So these are the basic practices, basic cyber hygiene principles. If you have to follow, if you follow, then you will be better protected against the social engineering attempt. So limit the information disclosure is the first thing. It should not be disclosed to all, or it should be restricted. So what type of IT infrastructure you are using? Sometimes we are preparing our resume and CV, and then we are pasting it or a LinkedIn profile, and then we are writing that I am working on this technology and using the server version 5.0. This is what is that? That's the basically information for an attacker to, okay, this organization or this individual is using this technology. So they will use that information against tricking the human being, tricking the employee of that target. So don't answer survey calls and don't get tricked into over the phone in a phishing attempt. Don't reveal your banking and net banking details to anyone, and don't share your password. Talk to employee about the security. Discuss in a formal or informal groups to make it interactive about the security issues and threats. Make them aware so that everyone should watch what they say and do. So that culture should be there within an organization. Centralized response and reporting. So designate an individual or a group, and you may have a media cell for the press inquiries, or the social engineer may use the following points of a contact, like survey calls, representatives, help desk call. So these calls and these responses should be handled by the centralized entity. So then recognize a pattern that can prevent a recognize. If you are able to recognize a pattern, can see a pattern in a phishing email, wishing, if you are aware about that, you can better respond to it and can prevent against the social engineering attack. So in summary of this session, that we have discussed the social engineering, what it is. So it's the manipulating the human being, manipulating your tendency to trick, trust. So tricking you, luring you to install some malicious program to get your bank details, banking details, or to get your IT infrastructure details, to compromise the networks. Then we discuss the techniques like shoulder surfing, like the physical attempts of a penetrative social engineering, such as dumpster diving. We discuss about the phishing, social engineering toolkit. We have discussed quick response code. We have discussed, then we have discussed the countermeasure. That's the key countermeasure, is the awareness of the people to defend against the social engineering. So that's all for this session. Thank you.